So, Shannon, will the Lakers go up 3-0 tonight?
Yes, and I expect the Lakers to approach the game as if they were down 2-1. They know what the Nuggets are capable of. They are a desperate team. And the thing is, Skip, when you look at the Nuggets, the Lakers got themselves in trouble, just like the Clippers, just like Utah in the series before, is that when you turn in the third quarter, if they turn you over, now they can become ultra-aggressive. They get to the free throw line. Because if you look at what they shot, they shot 33 free throws, 13 in the fourth quarter. So now they turn you over. You don't get an opportunity to score the basketball. They stop the clock. They go to the free throw. They trot to the free throw line. And you got to be able to weather that storm. And the Lakers did a good job. Anthony Davis did a good job of bailing them out. That was the old great decoy by old LeBron James. You saw LeBron just stand there. Everybody go right to him. Yeah.
I didn't understand.
Yeah,
decoy.
That's what I am, Skip. I'm the designated decoy. So I go out with my homeboys, and I pull out the parking lot. Police pull me over, think I had a little bit too much. Other people go home. But that's not here, though. That's what I'm saying. That decoy, you got to understand how that works, Skip. Playing it all alone.
I didn't get that.
You didn't understand that? No. That was a decoy. But anyway, I expect the Lakers, they understand we don't want to give this team life. And the one thing, because everybody's going to say, oh, they got life now, 2-1. They're right back in this thing. LeBron James, he's not going to do anything out of the ordinary. He's going to be LeBron James. And whatever the game dictates he needs to do, that's what he's going to do. We saw the first half. He saw second game. AD did not have it going. LeBron takes the game over in the first half. They jump out to the lead. The second half, AD takes it over. LeBron had 20 in the first half. AD has 22 in the second half. And that's what the luxury of having a great 1-2 punch. Because if one doesn't have it going, the other can bring it home. That's something the Clippers really never got, Skip. Either Kawhi had to... Kawhi really never could have an off game because Paul George never really could bring him through. Well, Paul George, if Kawhi is off, you can see what happened. It seemed like the Clippers, like, what is the basketball? What are we doing out here? They couldn't figure it out. They're getting timely shots. Danny Green's starting to chip in, giving them 11, 12 here and there. KCP chipping in here and there, getting great production off Dwight. Dwight needs to settle down because he got himself in foul. A lot of that, him trotting a yoke to the foul line. Skip, I love Yoke. I think he's the best big. I'm listing him as a five. I would take him over all other fives, including Joel Embiid, because I can count on him playing, and he's a better passer. He can score just as proficient. He's not the defender as Joel Embiid, but I would take him. But he's no match for AD. And I expect AD to have another monster game, and I expect the Lakers to go up 3-0. Can I get some dew on it?
So, quick question.
Yes, you can.
In cross-examination.
Yes.
You predicted before this series started Lakers in six.
Yeah.
So are you going to predict then after it goes to 3-0 that the Nuggets are going to win games 4 and 5?
No, they'll win game 4.
Is that right?
And then we'll finish up in 5.
Oh.
Yeah, my estimation might have been a little off.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, you were trying to make the path harder than it really is. Well, you're trying to give some credibility to the path LeBron has to another championship.
Well, actually, Skip, you know, I didn't anticipate, you know, AD having to hit a 28-footer at the buzzer.
Neither did I. another quick note before I proceed into what I'm about to say and unleash. Do you realize that routinely the Clippers against the Nuggets were 8.5-point favorites just every night until game 7, then they were only 7-point favorites? And routinely the Lakers are only 6 or 6.5-point favorites. So again, the odds makers are actually saying the Clippers were stronger than the Lakers.
The odds makers need to shut up. They need to shut up because they got bankrupt messing with the Nuggets just 2 weeks ago. Yeah, and everybody, oh, the Clippers. And the Nuggets just steady cashing people betting on the Nuggets and steady cashing chips.
So the odds makers paid more respect to the Clippers than the Lakers, duly noted.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
That's why I picked the Clippers to beat the Lakers.
And you and the odds maker are wrong.
So here we go again. This feels all meant to be to me. It's like the Lakers are on this meant to be roll in the wake of the late, great Kobe Bryant. Mm-hmm. It feels like they're fueled by Kobe's memory. Mm-hmm. This is their time to rise and shine and do this for Kobe. And it feels like they just keep getting every break they can get.
What break did they get now?
Well, they drew Portland in the
first. Oh, but
Portland was 35-39 in the regular season. And I'm saying this is a joke, and it was a joke. It should have been over in four, but it was over in five because LeBron blew the last 7 minutes of the first game. Had it right in the palm of his hand, literally 6-point lead with 7 minutes to go, and couldn't get that home against that team, the worst defensive team in the bubble.
Uh-huh.
Really. Then the Rockets, right on schedule, after they win game one convincingly, lose game two. It's one all, and Daniel House bubble burst. And he's gone from the bubble. We all know why. And it wrecked the psyche of the Rockets. And they basically just rolled over and quit.
We rolled them over. Yep. That ain't roll over. We rolled them over.
So here we go again with game two. And LeBron James can't lose for winning. He even gets a break when he goes into his shell and he freezes and he hides on the last play.
Decoy.
It was called for LeBron. Mm-hmm. They called it in the huddle because you got to pay that homage to LeBron. He's LeBron James. And the only other time in his career happened to be that game in Chicago, that playoff game when, what's his name?
David Blatt.
Dearly departed David Blatt. he has the audacity to call the last play for Kyrie, which is, that makes sense to me. And LeBron said, no way. Give me the damn ball.
You know what, Skip? It wasn't the fact that he said that he wanted Kyrie to take the shot. He wanted LeBron to take the ball out.
He did. Correct.
LeBron said, miss me with your foolishness.
Correct. And LeBron got mad. And I always tell you, I love LeBron when he plays mad because it's not often. And he just took the inbounds pass. I can't remember if Kyrie threw it inbounds. I doubt it. Mm-hmm. Probably came from somebody else. But he just goes right up and shoots it. It wasn't a three, but it was a long two from the corner. It's a hard shot.
Buzzer beater.
And he ripped it at the buzzer. And it saved their bacon because they were starting to get in trouble against Derrick Rose and company and Noah.
Had them all along.
Right? Okay. So here we go again. It's 2.1 seconds left. Denver almost got the rebound off a Caruso missed three, which was predictable, and they couldn't quite come up with the basketball.
Yeah.
So it's 2.1 left, Lakers inbounds. Rondo says, put me in, coach. Good. We'll let you throw it in. And they call the play, as they should have, for LeBron James. And if we could see this one more time.
Decoy.
He just stands still because
decoy. Tim, that ain't the best
LeBron,
decoy.
LeBron, move.
Don't move. Don't
LeBron,
move, LeBron.
It's your call.
Don't
it's
move, LeBron. Stand right there. Look at him. Walk up.
What? So let's put this in context. LeBron James in the fourth quarter was 1-for-6. He was 0-for-3 from three, and he had created or committed two turnovers. So he's just saying, I want no part of this play.
That's not what he's.
Yes, he was. He just froze. Do goats hide on the last play
Skip
of
Bayless.
Games?
Skip.
It's a goat who hid.
Skip, you and I both know this was the play design. And you draw it up like this. Skip, are you upset? Look, when I look at it, like, let's take the moth and the flame. I don't have to move the flame because the moth is attracted to it. LeBron didn't have to move. He knew two would come to him. And one would have to be guarding Anthony Davis. So what he did is that he drew two. AD got a wide open jumper for the bucket.
So help me out. Mason Plumlee ran straight to LeBron for what reason? LeBron is not moving, and it's only 2.1 seconds,
but see, that's
so
there's
not time for much to happen.
This is what I love about it. The NBA have sideline cameras, and before the play, Grant is telling Plumlee, I want you to come right here. Come right here. Go look it up. He's thinking that LeBron is going to do something funny. And Plumlee runs right to where Grant has instructed him to come. And guess what happened? It worked to out because Frankie V on top of his game, called it, knew what was going
to
happen.
Did AD run to pick for LeBron?
No, he didn't have to.
No, he did not.
He didn't
Mason,
have
to. And I love Mason Plumlee. He's a sharp. He's a Duke kid.
Yeah.
High IQ basketball.
Yeah.
What are you doing, Mason? What's in your head? What's your thought process? He is running free across the top of the circle to the far wing. Maybe you should run with him.
We're going to put – tomorrow I'm going to have this video because I'm going to show you what Jeremy Grant instructed Mason Plumlee to do. He instructed him to come. I want you to come right here.
Why would he instruct him to do that?
Because he thought LeBron was going to do something to him.
Do what?
Get the ball and put a jumper in his eyes.
To do that, you would need somebody to come and pick for you.
No.
And nobody was picking for you. You were standing still.
Yeah. LeBron could body little Jeremy Grant. He ain't got enough bricks in his back pocket to tie him down when that storm come.
The classic quote came from Rajon Rondo after the game. I locked eyes with LeBron, and he did not move.
Exactly.
Uh-huh.
That's what he was supposed to do.
That's called... I freeze, I hide. Really? I want no part of this
Stop
play.
It.
You know it, and I know
AD,
it.
AD, oh, look.
And he got away
Hold
with
on.
It.
First of all.
And AD took him off the hook.
AD's walking back. He said that was a great decoy by LeBron James. That's what AD said.
I did not hear a word about that.
Hey, I'm gonna have my IG people send it to you. That's what he's saying.
Okay, I don't read any of my mentions. So
No. You need to read it.
Bring it to the show tomorrow.
Okay, I'm gonna bring it to the show tomorrow. AD's talking about, but I'm also gonna bring to the show the cut up where they're saying Jeremy Grant is instructing a Plumlee to come there.
Come there for what?
Because that's LeBron James.
Oh.
That's LeBron James.
I don't think Jeremy Grant is afraid of LeBron
James.
I don't.
In that moment, he was.
I don't believe
In that
he
moment.
He wasn't afraid of Kawhi Leonard.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
There's your first mistake. You keep trying to compare Kawhi to that guy. I told you he was the full king. Oh, Jenny, did you see that little crown he had? He took a shot. That's the new king.
Oh, yeah.
This is Kawhi town. Mm. I said, Skip, don't do that.
So let's just get rid of the Nuggets. I wish they would just call
No.
I don't have anything to do tonight except watch the Lakers.
Nope.
But still, why would I subject myself to this kind of torment? Because this will be a 20-point Laker win tonight. The Nuggets just got shot in the heart.
They got a tremendous 1-2 punch. Everybody knows what Jamal Murray is capable of doing. We saw that in the games 5, 6, and 7. Mm-hmm. We saw it early in the series against Utah. We saw a 40-point game 7. We saw that against the best defensive team in basketball with all those dogs and all those lockdown defenders.
So how are the Lakers going to win game 3?
What you mean?
You said it was easy.
Whoa. Hold on, time out, Skip. The difference
is it?
Hold on. Clippers. Lakers. This is always LA's always gonna be a Laker town.
So what do the Lakers win by tonight? One? You're making or maybe by half a point?
No, I'm gonna give you the point. I give you the spread.
Only six.
Okay.
I don't want any part of it because the Lakers are gonna win by 20. I'm gonna give you the spread.
No, you can give me that.
Yes, you
nothing.
Can have it.
No,
bet
no,
against
no,
them.
No,
you
no,
said
no.
It's gonna be a close
why
game.
Why would I bet against?
You said it was gonna be Lakers in six. So Nuggets got to win one of these games.
Yeah.
Right.
So hold on, Skip. I said as long as the Lakers win, it can be 4. It can be 3. I don't care. As long as we win this thing and hold up that trophy. I told you at the beginning of the year, when they got AD, I said, I'm going to the parade. Yeah. Now, you know, every time I told you I'm going to a parade, I told you in 2016, I came on your show for the very first time. I said, Skip, I'm going to drive me a fire truck in the parade, and I invite you.
And by the way, you switched your pick at the last second while we were going off air. And I said, I'll give you a chance to amend your pick, and you did. You jumped right off the bandwagon.
Yeah.
Okay, so you probably jump off this one.
No.
This is an all-time cakewalk, and I'll just...
And I'll just give you...
I'll sum it up for you. It's like rock, paper, scissors. The Clippers were the rock that would have busted up your scissors,
no,
your Lakers scissors.
No, we dynamite.
But the Nuggets were the paper that covered rock.
Skip.
That's what happened.
This is what I don't get. Okay, this is what they told us. When the hottest team in the bubble, with the bubble MVP... Dame Lillard and the Portland Trailblazers, the greatest 8-seed team in NBA history.
You didn't hear that from me.
The Lakers dispatched them. Ooh, that small ball. James Harden, Russell Westbrook, raining threes, yada, yada, yada. Dispatched them. Okay, the Clippers. Ooh, the Clippers. They don't want to see the Clippers. Okay. Let's just let the Clippers get past the Nuggets. Mm. Y'all up 3-1. You over there pounding your chair.
Yep.
Woo!
I was.
I thought you the Wolf of Wall Street.
Yep.
Jordan Bell. Boom, boom, boom.
Yep.
Look at old Skip over there celebrating.
Yep.
You, Clipper Darryl, Marcellus Wiley, everybody, Clipper Nation. Clip,
yep.
Clip.
Yep.
Clip, clip. Hey, well, guess what happened? Clippers,
you
flippers,
got so
slippers.
Lucky.
You're going and selling.
You got so lucky.
No, but how did we get lucky, Skip? Y'all were up 3-1.
I got Lakers by 20 today.
No, 20. No.
Book it.
No. Yep. We winning this game. Watch that 1-2 punch. Mm. Watch that 1-2 punch.
Are you making a case
watch
for the
Nuggets? Watch that 1-2 punch. Yeah. No. Hold on. We got the baddest 1-2 punch.
Oh, those guys.
Yeah, but you make it seem like Jokic and Murray some chumps.
You got one punch, and that's AD.
So hold on. So LeBron James is averaging 26, 10, and 8 in the playoffs, and he getting carried by AD now.
Goats don't hide on the last
Really,
run.
Skip?
Yep, really.
Really?
Yep.
I mean, you're going to say that with a...
Yeah, I said it with a straight face because you know I'm right about it.
So since when is 26, 10, and 8 chicken feed?
He rolls out of bed and has those numbers.
Well, why your guy didn't have those numbers? Why your guy? You always talk about my guy froze down the stretch. Did my guy have a better, a worse fourth quarter than your guy had the last half of
he
game seven?
One bad fourth quarter.
Well, you can't have a bad fourth quarter if it's game seven because you're going home.
Thank you for watching. You can subscribe here to get the latest from the show and be sure to check out more of the best clips from Undisputed or go watch a few other segments from our other shows on FS1.